हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लुकमान आईएएस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द हिंदू एनालिसिस ऑफ 29th मार्च 2021। सो लेट अस सी विच आर द इम्पोर्टेंट आर्टिकल्स इन टुडेज द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर। यस, दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट आर्टिकल्स। यस, वी हैव सेग्रीगेटेड देम फॉर मेंस रिलेटेड एंड फॉर प्रीलिम्स रिलेटेड आर्टिकल्स। लेट अस टेक ओवरव्यू ऑफ दीज आर्टिकल्स फर्स्ट। यस, ओपेसिटी रूल्स ऑन पेज नंबर 6, एडिटोरियल पेज। अगेन, it is having the context of Supreme Court verdict on electoral bond schemes. Yes, so let us understand what the Supreme Court has said in this particular verdict. At the same time, the analysis, the article is providing the issues involved in this particular electoral bond scheme. Yes, earlier we have discussed this, again the follow up on that same issue. So GS2 paper, polity part. Next, tackling the period taboo. So on page number 7, op-ed page, from society, ethics and essay, relevance, this particular article is discussing about the stigma associated with menstruation and how women are being discriminated on this particular issue, be it in public places or even they are facing such issues and denied the dignified life or equal opportunities for development in society. So from essay society GS1 and ethics GS4 paper, we will take input accordingly. Center mulls unique ID for all plots of land by March 2022. So in one of the report of the parliamentary committee, which has said that the government has come up with this unique ID, ULPIN, unique land identification number. So this particular unique ID for lands, this is important developments in terms of land reforms. So in GS3 paper, we have to take input. At the same time, from the governance aspect also, this is important reform that is being brought by the government. So we'll understand what is this reform here. Next is from prelims perspective, specifically 27 migratory birds found dead at wildlife sanctuary in Himachal. So it is having the context of or talking about the Pong Dam wildlife sanctuary. So what is this Pong Dam and the Maharana Pratap Sagar dam or reservoir? So basics about that. Then next is Mountbatten's bracelet, other artifact auction. So it is having the context of Lord Mountbatten. So again, from modern history perspective, what was Lord Mountbatten? What was Mountbatten's plan of India's partition? So, and transfer of powers. So from history perspective, prelims related some inputs that we can take from this article. Yes, let us go into details of all these articles. First, opacity rules. So from GS2 paper, polity part, electoral reforms. Yes, this particular electoral reform was brought by the government in a view to curb black money, use of black money in electoral funding. So this electoral bond scheme sought to bring some more transparency in electoral funding and remove the black money or funding through black money for such elections. However, there were many such issues raised in the implementation, at the same time its structure of the scheme. So yes, at present the Supreme Court was hearing one particular petition for stopping of implementation of this scheme before some assembly elections like Tamil Nadu and West Bengal elections that are going on. However, the Supreme Court has given the go ahead to this electoral bond scheme and said that there was implementation or release of such bonds in 2018-19-20 without any legal impediment. So there are certain safeguards provided in court's interim judgment in 2019. So what are these certain safeguards that are provided, that we have to understand? Along with that, what are the issues involved in this electoral bond scheme? Yes, in 2019, the Supreme Court has said that all political parties are supposed to provide all the details of funds they have received in closed envelope to Election Commission of India. This was the interim judgment, right? At the same time, it had reduced the amount of, or we can say window of selling of that day further, time period, okay. So this is how it has sought to provide certain safeguards in reducing any kind of corruption or black money involved in electoral funding. At the same time, it had raised certain concerns that weighty issues which have tremendous bearing on sanctity of electoral process in the country were involved in this particular scheme. And that's why the Supreme Court was in future going to analyze, examine this particular electoral bond scheme. However, at present, a liberal view is taken in this particular judgment of the Supreme Court. Now, analyzing. So, analysis of present judgment. So, present judgment is to some extent going back to what earlier in 2019 Supreme Court has said. Okay. So, what are the issues involved in this electoral bond scheme? The major issue is of anonymity of donors. The issue of anonymity of donors. So, here the corporate donors under such cloak of anonymity can fund electoral parties or political parties and their candidates without any upward capping or the higher capping or ceiling. This is a lack of transparency, we can say that, in the scheme involved, right? So such shell companies can be formed and the foreign funding can be rerouted through these shell companies. Okay, so this is again another issue. The link between contributions and policy making remains impenetrable to citizens. Yes, surely, suppose any big company is there and that big company is funding a particular political party in general elections, and surely it will seek certain favors in return when the party is coming to the power, right? So this is not understood by the common people who are voting in the general elections, right? So this is this we can say that right to know, which is a fundamental right recognized by Supreme Court from time to time now, and after having the complete information with the let's say citizen of India, then only he will take the aware decision to whom he wants to vote and to which party he wants to vote, right? So this is how we have to understand the issues involved. Along with that, the Supreme Court has said that yes, there is transparency in this scheme, and surely one can understand which party is being funded by which company. However, the parties declare a cumulative figure of amounts received through bonds and not details about it. No inference can be drawn by the company's disclosure of its total contribution to one or more political parties. So details cannot be known, only the total sum is funded by the company and total sum is received by a political party. How many companies, which companies are paying how much or contributing how much, it is not known. Okay, so this is how we have to understand the issues involved here and what kind of question we can expect. Discuss the issues involved in the electoral bond scheme with special reference to Supreme Court judgments on continuance of the scheme. So 2019 judgment and this one to 2021 judgment that you need to have follow up on and no details of. Fine. So GS2 paper polity part. Next, tackling the period taboo. So again, from society, social justice and ethics paper, essay paper. Here, the issues faced by women in our society, and one of the issues being discussed here is the stigma associated with menstruation. Okay, so the issue that happened or instance that happened in February 2020, college authorities including principal of Sri Sahajanand Girls Institute in Bhuj, Gujarat, allegedly forced over 60 girls to remove their undergarments to check if they were menstruating. Now this is the situation that women in our society are facing, and many such instances happens, but many of them are not reported. Now this particular instance shows that women, Indian women specifically in Indian society, are facing discrimination on the basis of gender or sex. So yes, in Sabarimala case, one of the judge, he had said that any social practice which excludes women from participation in public life as a result of their menstruation is discriminatory on the ground of their sex. And under Article 14 of Indian Constitution and Article 15 of Indian Constitution, yes, surely they protect right to equality on the basis of gender, or gender equality we can say that, and state cannot discriminate on the basis of sex or gender. At the same time, Article 14 ensures right to equality. Okay, so such kind of discrimination is impermissible under Article 14 of Indian Constitution. It is talking about right to equality. Right to equality. So this right to equality under Article 19 is being denied to Indian women in such instances. At the same time, another fundamental right is denied, that is fundamental right under Article 21. Right to have dignified life. This is included in under Article 21 of Indian Constitution. So that is right to life and liberty, personal liberty. So dignified, respectful life in society is fundamental right of every person in India, and surely this is being denied when such instances are happening. Okay, so along with that, we have to understand that women are not able to fully participate in the society and realize their potential because of such practices in our society. So yes, surely women empowerment and issues related women, related to women, the essay topic will be there. Surely every year they are asking such kind of question, essay topic related to gender justice, women empowerment. Okay, along with that, gender equality or human rights, human values, yes, they are part of GS4 paper, ethics paper, along with that GS1 society part, or issues faced by women in Indian society. And now this particular instance was recognized suo motu by Gujarat High Court, and various measures were taken. So that is not important, but issues we have to understand, that how it impacts human rights, fundamental rights of women in our society. So yes, deliberate on the issue of women in India facing stigma attached to menstruation. GS1 paper, we can expect such question. Essay topic, dream of society where women can freely live dignified lives, nurturing all facets of their womanhood. So are we having such a dream, getting converted into reality, especially in Indian society? So surely we have to understand the reality on the ground in Indian society, and how the government is taking measures, along with that how society is progressing and the way forward. Surely you can write such essay topic when we are talking about women's issues in India. Next, Center mulls unique ID for all plots of land by March 22. So it is talking about this ULPIN, unique land parcel identification number. ULPIN scheme that is launched in 10 such states on the pilot basis this year, and will be rolled out across all the states by March 2022. Now this is important developments in land reform. So earlier we know that digitalization of land records was taken up by UPA government. Digitalization of land records. So now this particular initiative ULPIN will also ensure that Digital India Land Records Modernization Program, that was the earlier Land Records Modernization and Digitalization Program. Now that started in 2008 by UPA government, and now it is extended or modified under this ULPIN scheme. Okay, so this is being described as Aadhaar for land. This will allocate a particular number to a plot, particular plot, and it will ensure that the data or the records of or land records are properly maintained, and they are transferred whenever there is any transaction. So this particular land will number will be assigned to that plot, and this will be fixed. Okay, so it will ensure, the significance is that the number would uniquely identify every surveyed parcel of land, prevent land fraud, especially in rural India where land records are outdated and disputed. This is the significance, land reforms. At the same time, when the land records are organized, surely it will help farmers, landless, not landless rural, farmers to avail the credit in from the banks. Okay, so this will also reduce the litigation related to land, because in rural India most of the litigation is related to land dispute and family dispute. Now the technology will be used here, like yes, drones and the detailed surveys, geo-referenced maps, they will be used, and then ultimately the unique identification number will be allocated to plots. Fine. So from land reforms, you need to remember this scheme, ULPIN. Next, 27 migratory birds found dead at wildlife sanctuary in Himachal. So this wildlife sanctuary is Pong Dam Wildlife Sanctuary. So basics about Pong Dam location, you can see here Himachal Pradesh. This is the location of Pong Dam on Bias River. Bias River is tributary of Indus River. Fine. So now we have understood that it is also known as Bias Dam because of it is built across Bias River in Himachal Pradesh. The reservoir which is formed is known as Maharana Pratap Sagar Reservoir, and yes, it is recognized as Ramsar site, internationally important Ramsar site under Ramsar Convention. So bird sanctuary, many migratory birds come to Pong Dam Wildlife Sanctuary, especially in winter season. Fine. Okay, next. Yes, what kind of question we can expect here? Let us try to solve this question. Yes, consider the following statements about Pong Dam. It is located in Arunachal Pradesh. No, this is incorrect statement. It is located in Himachal Pradesh. It is built across Brahmaputra River. No, it is not built across Brahmaputra River. Rather, it is built across Bias River. So those who do not know exactly Pong Dam, so from this particular Pong name, one can get confused. It should be in Northeast India. Okay, so you need to know exact information. Yes, it is used for power generation and irrigation purpose. This is correct statement. So yes, we have to identify the incorrect statements. So first two, one and two. So the A should be the answer. So one should be very careful whether the command is talking about correct or incorrect statements. Okay, moving on. Mountbatten's bracelet and other artifacts auction. So here a particular auction by a granddaughter of, eldest daughter of Lord Louis Mountbatten, the last Viceroy of India, this happened, and that's why it was in news. Now the Lord Mountbatten, basic information about him, because he is related to modern history of India, noted personality. Why? Because the Mountbatten plan was the last plan that was agreed to, Muslim League as well as Indian National Congress. So that's why it is important, and it was successfully implemented. Yes, he was last Viceroy of India and first Governor General of Independent India also. What was this Mountbatten plan that was put forward on 3rd June 1947? There, India will be divided into, yes, British India would be divided into India and Pakistan. Bengal and Punjab provinces will be partitioned, and a referendum in Northeast Frontier Province and Sillet district of Assam would be held. So these two referendum were included in Pakistan. There would be a separate constituent assembly for Pakistan that will frame separate constitution. At the same time, this particular plan asked the princely states, we can say, they can enjoy the liberty to join either India or Pakistan or even remain independent. Now, this was again the contentious provision here, remain independent. So, there was cause of concern because some of the states like Junagadh or Hyderabad state did not want to join any of the independent country here. Along with that, the transfer of power, date of transfer of power was decided as 15th August 1947. This was the Mountbatten plan, last of all those plans, like Cripps mission was there and cabinet mission plan, and then we have this Mountbatten plan, right? Okay, so from modern history there can be question, try to take input, some factual data is required. Yes, some good statements that can be used, like Justice D.Y. Chandrachud in Sabarimala case, just now we talked about this. Any social practice which excludes women from participation in public life as a result of their menstruation is discriminatory on the ground of their sex. You can directly quote this in essay paper, GS4 paper also, GS1 paper also. Along with that, the stigma attached to the menstruation and restrictions in private and public life duration for the duration of menstruation have long been part of women's lives in India. The stigma finds its root in the notion of purity and pollution principle attached historical to menstruation. Purity and pollution. This is also attached to the caste system in India and menstruation when we talk about women related. So, in society, GS1 paper and essay paper, you can use them. Fine? Okay, so these were important captions and quotations. Yes, these are the articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. You can take input accordingly for mains examination as well as prelims examination. For further information on editorial discussion classes or ED classes, wherein in-depth analysis of mains related issues and articles, just now we discussed about the judgment in the polity part, Supreme Court judgment on electoral bond scheme, that will be in detail discussed by Ansari sir and team in those ED lectures. For further information about that course, you can contact Lukman IAS.